गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट पार्ट टू ऑफ द चैप्टर विमेन चेंज द वर्ल्ड। दिस इज द सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट लर्निंग फॉर चेंज, स्कूलिंग एंड एजुकेशन टुडे, स्पेशली फॉर गर्ल्स बिकॉज वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट विमेन और गर्ल्स। इन दिस वीडियो स्पेशली विल डिस्कस अबाउट एजुकेशन, विच आस्पेक्ट education for girls and women. We start the discussion with 18th century or even 19th century. In the 19th century, girls and women were not allowed to get education in the society, in all the religious communities, in all the castes and different communities, girls and women were not allowed to get education like men or like boys. Why? If we take example of Muslims, in Muslim community, it was thought and considered that if women and girls would be educated, they would be corrupted by reading the romanticism or romantic shayari of Ghalib, Mirza Ghalib, like that. In Hindu community, what was the thinking of the people, of the conservative people? That if women got education, they would be widow very soon. They would be having bad luck, right? So due to these kinds of traditional thinking, women and girls were not allowed to get education. But some women changed the scenario. We are taking the example of such women. First example, Rasha Sundari Devi. This is the first example, Rasa Sundari Devi in Bengali, and if we write in English, then we can write Devi. So Rasa Sundari Devi, she was born in 1800 and died in 1890 in West Bengal. In West Bengal, at that time it was just Bengal, not West Bengal. Today, if we see the location of the birthplace, today that is West Bengal. She was born in Bengal. She did not get education in schools, but she learned how to read the books, how to read, right, in secrecy at her kitchen. Her husband was very liberal person and he helped her to learn reading and later writing. So Rasa Sundari Devi started to read the books, and after that she started to write the books. At the age of 60, she wrote her autobiography. Name of her autobiography was Amar Jeevan. This autobiography was published in 1876. She has explained in her autobiography that how she started to read and how she learned reading and then writing, and what kind of problems she faced and what kind of situation were there when she started to learn in secrecy in her own home, right? And after that she described about that how she started to read about Chaitanya Bhagat, right, life of a saint. Then and one more feature of Amar Jeevan, that it was the first full-length autobiography in Bengali language. In which language? In Bengali language, by any Indian women, written by any Indian women. So this is a very good example of women of 19th century. Those she started to learn how to read and write in the adverse conditions, when the people were not favoring women education or girls education. So this is the example of Rasa Sundari Devi. And the most important achievement of Rasa Sundari Devi, her autobiography published in 1876. Second example we can take Pandita Ramabai. She was a girl from Maharashtra. She did not go to school. She never went to school. But in spite of that, her parents learned her, taught her, right, how to learn reading and writing. And one more special thing about Pandita Ramabai, that she knew the language Sanskrit, and it was very difficult at that time for women especially to learn Sanskrit, because even women and girls were not allowed to get education, they did not go to school, so Sanskrit, how could they learn Sanskrit? But Pandita Ramabai, she knew how to read and write Sanskrit. Clear? If we see the lifespan, 58, and died in 1922. This was the lifespan of Pandita Ramabai. She knew Sanskrit language, so she got the title of Pandita. Clear? Because she knew Sanskrit. She had the knowledge of Sanskrit language. She supported the girls' education, and she sought to start the education and the new scenario for women education and the girls education in the society. Next example we can take Begum Rokeya Shekhawat Hussain. This is another example. She was born in 1880 and died in 1932. She was a great Muslim educationist and Muslim social reformer, and also we can say that feminist, because she supported women education. She was completely against the society, the thinking of the society, those who were not in favor of women education. Shekhawat Hussain, she also means belonging to a very high class family, and she had the knowledge of Urdu language, but she was not allowed to learn English and other languages, right? But then she learned how to speak, how to write, how to read English language, and then she in 1905 she wrote a novel that was very famous novel named Sultana's Dream. This novel was written by Rokeya Shekhawat Hussain. She supported women education, especially Muslim women education, and she wanted to uplift the situation and condition of Muslim girls and Muslim women. So these are three examples. One more example we can take Tarabai Shinde. This is the example from Maharashtra. She also started to learn and how to read, how to speak, how to write the language. Clear? Then she started to read the language, and after that she got education, right? So this is also one kind of example, and all the examples of these girls and women, they learned, they taught themselves, and with the help of some liberal people in their families, they got the education. Informally they got education without going to school, but later they wrote about the miserable lives of women. They wrote about the widows' conditions. They wrote about the social circumstances against women, and then they also suggested the reforms for girls and women education. So dear students, you have to remember the name of Rasu Sundari Devi, Pandita Ramabai, Rokeya Shekhawat Hussain. After that, if we see schooling and education today, if we compare today's condition to the 19th century condition, completely different, right? Now the girls are more liberal to get education. In spite of this, the women and girls are facing a lot of problems in the society, because India is the patriarchal society, and here male domination society, we can say. So girls and women still are facing a lot of problems because of the traditional thinking of most of the people in our country. So if we take example of sex ratio, that is 944 only according to 2011. If we take example of 2001, it was just only 933. In 1991, it was just 929. we can say that the big discrimination with women and exploitation of women and the traditional thinking of the society. One more thing, if we compare education, then in 1961, according to the census of 1961, boys' literacy rate was 40% and girls' literacy rate was only 15%. Clear? What is literacy rate? Literacy rate means the percentage of total population, out of total population of literate people. Clear? How many people are literate out of total population? So what is literate? Literate is a word that is used for a person who is of 7 or of more than 7 years of age, can write and read with understanding any language, any one language, can be called a literate person. So the number of literate people known as literacy rate, to 1961 only 15% means girls out of total population, women were literate, and 40% boys or male. If we take example of 2011, so total literacy rate is 74.04%, 74.04% total literacy rate, clear? Out of which 82%, approximately 82% male literacy, and for women only 65% female literacy. So there is difference between the girls literacy and boys literacy, we can say, in the country. So in this way we can say that in schooling and education today also, in the sphere of education, girls and women are lagging behind in comparison of men and boys, etc. Clear? So dear students, in this way we have discussed this part. I hope that you understood the concept of today's video. You have to revise by reading from the text, and you can also watch this video again to understand this concept better. Clear? If you have any doubt, you can write me in the comment box. Thank you. Have a nice day.